I'm back! They can't hold me down. Abolish this! And please don't target me. I don't see the broadcast. How do I... Can I see it here? Direpithum Annihilator. Huh. Oh, it must be this one. I can't. I don't know what I just did. Yeah, I don't think we were supposed to do this mission this way, but if we can do it, so be it. I like how he's velocity tanking this stuff. That's pretty cool. And he's, like, constantly draining this thing's capacitor and stealing it for his shields and stuff. Yeah. Oh, God. Oh, God. Not again. Less typing, more warping. Saves money on repair bills. I'm not so sure about this ship for PvE. It's not really, doesn't do a lot of damage, and it can't take a lot of damage. Perhaps if I put a micro warp drive and some rockets on it, it would be okay for bursting someone down really quickly, maybe? But, I don't know. Seems like maybe not the best fitting, especially because I can't put anything else on it if I want to keep any semblance of damage up. Like, look, it's completely maxed out, even with the power diagnostic system on. Maybe if I... No, I'd have to remove all of these to put this on, and even then... Yeah, that would be about it. And then that's no recharge at all. What about... Nope. Cap stable. I guess we could try it like this. That's sort of less squishy. I don't know. It might actually make a difference. God damn it, no repair facilities. Now this is a good way to really test my ship. Fly to the star. I'm getting warmer! Time to kick on the afterburner and hope that the sun can't actually kill you. Time to get off in that SPF 1 billion sunblock. Yeah. Gonna give another level 2 a go. Not really feeling this ship for the PvP or PvE at all, but I still wanna see how it do. Oh, I remember this mission. Gotta fly over to the other gate. That one. I'm really curious to see what this resistance mod is gonna do on something that has like 5 shields. 1100 shields. I could find out though. It should be stable-ish. And what's my effective HP? Ooh, that actually... put it up quite a bit. Maybe not a bad idea. No, it didn't. It put it up by about 3,500. Yes, 3,500 is a correct way of calculating things. It's math, trust me. Oh, my favorite sentry guns. And they are on me, of course. Of course! Ow. Oh, that's not good. That's not good one little bit. But I've almost got one of the sentry guns down. Come on, don't make me repair! Goody. I don't think those were proper level 2s anyway. I think they were supposed to skip them level 2s and just complete the objectives, but still. I think I want to find out more about this ship. It's definitely not capable of doing level 3s, ever, in any way. Probably not level 2s either. And I kind of do like this resistance tanking on it. Well, it's my only real option with the build, so why not? I've seen ships spitting in station, but we are forming a yin and yang of orange and blue. This is lovely. Oh god. Oh man, that is pretty. Finally, hopefully some real level 2 combat, and this time I'm bringing the frigate, because honestly, it's just as good as the destroyer. That destroyer is useless for PvE. Come on, old girl, let's tank it up with speed! This is a Kestrel, by the way. My ship is named the Floppy Disk. It's just... I don't know why, but it reminds me a great deal of a floppy disk. With missiles on it. Which is pretty cool, you know, when you think about it. I want to be first. Me! Me, first to fight, first to die! See you later, suckers! Oh boy. I found friends! I don't even know what the targeting range on this thing is. Or what the missile range is, for that matter. 35? That's not bad. It's manslayers. Time to slay some slayers. And transport ships. That's more my speed. Pew pew rockets. Or missiles. Did I just fucking miss? God damn it. I think I missed. Oh wait, this guy's closer. Oh no. I put the miss in missiles! Oh no, I hit him! Wow, I did more than just hit him, I killed him outright. Now this is a level 2 mission. And I'm being tracking jammed. That's not a very good idea to do against a missile frigate. But who am I to judge you, NPC pirates? Oh, shit. I need to be going faster and shieldier. But this ship's actually pretty nice. As you can see, it's doing a much better job than the destroyer was, although we were fighting out of our league a little bit, so... I suppose that's an issue as well. It does similar damage, though, even with only 4 launchers, which is a bit discouraging, I suppose. Whoops. I meant to do that. I know, it's not wormhole stuff, but it's nice to test ship fits and stuff and just sort of hang out with people and do missions. Don't need to get all high-end on us. I still get to watch the boom-booms. Like that. It's a little bit more dogfighty, too. I like it. I'm gonna go ram him. I didn't get to ram anything with my submarine, and that made me sad, so... I'll try it with my friggy pie. No. That's more like it. Still been occasionally hopping out to do some mining, which is good. Did some selling of the ores as well, so we've been sort of fluctuating. The price of Veldspar has been going up recently pretty high, so I've been trying to sell it off as quickly as I can get it. Anyway, what we're going to do now is go to our new ship that I picked up, the Drake. It is a large missile-based battle shiznip, and we are going to fit it out with a bunch of battle shiznip. Or it's not a battleship, it's a battle cruiser. And it is largely based on being extremely strong and tankified with the right fittings, and doing relatively solid damage with heavy missile launchers, which I've trained up a little bit recently. Not to maximum potential, but to hopefully just some potential. There's an extra high launcher slot, which is for usually for warfare links. You can put whatever you want on it, though. I guess for the purposes of just looking at base DPS, I'll toss in a bunch of missiles. What? No. And see what our basic DPS and tanking abilities on this thing are gonna be. Also want to know what the range on these guys is. 40 kilometers, that's okay. Let's see here. 83 DPS, that is really fucking pathetic. However, we can improve that with a number of modules and fits, and I will go about the process of doing that now. Alright, so I've got this thing sort of fitted out a little bit, and even at that, what's my max speed with this thing? 314, oh yeah. But it's got some decent tank, considering I can't use the correct field thingamabobs. One thing I am going to do, though, is insure my Drake first. 13 mil for a 43 mil payout. Damn, that's pretty good. I'll take it. Man, I'm happy with that insurance, although the 13 mil does hurt a bit. Let's see here. We're operating mostly on resistance type tanking. Nothing particularly sexy, just some EM and thermal wards, and an adaptive invulnerability field, which when I have active gives me an EHP of around 23,000. And the sad thing is the HP per second regenerate on my shield is pretty low because I can't use the medium slot ones yet. I will use them when I can, and I'll be able to replace these two with more ballistic control systems to increase my DPS, which is pretty sad right now. But I've got my drones too. I don't think that number is correct either because I'm switching up to hammerheads for this one, but I've got to finish the medium drone training to get them to be active. Other than that, I think it should be okay. The only issue is that I'm going to be joining up with Avok to do a level 4 mission, and since my only attack range is 40 kilometers, it's going to be likely that I will be targeted and need to warp away, and some of these enemies will have webifiers and warp scramblers. So that's why I wanted to insure my ship, because it is very possible that I will lose it here. I don't really care that much. The only real damage to it would be the loss of the modules, and that would be around, I think, 10 mil-ish in modules, maybe more, probably not much more, but yeah, I don't think that's going to hurt us too much as long as I keep my economic stuff moving after this, but it should be a good fun way for me to test out the Drake in a difficult environment. He'll be flying a Paladin, which is a Marauder class super weapon of ultimate destruction. I believe it is, let's see if I can find it here. Galente, maybe? No, that's not it. It's Amar. This thing. Yeah. This is a... How much does this guy cost? About a billion. No big deal. It's real purdy, though. And it's basically just hell on wheels. If it had wheels, which it doesn't! Anyway, I'll get him in here in a minute. Are you waiting for me there, or am I holding you up?
No, I'm in Todaki. I was just mentioning that once you land in system, let me know, and I'll warp us to the engagement.
Okay, I'm 4 jumps out of Todaki. I'm in, like, Surikawa right now. I had to stop and insure the ship.
Wise move, honestly.
Yeah, 43 million payout. That's pretty damn good.
Yeah, it's a tier 1 hull, so you'll get a fairly good payout on it.
Yep.
Alright, well, I'm gonna go grab a drink while I wait, and she'll be back in just a moment.
Probably fucking tea, huh?
What else?
Why, yes, Avak, I am ready to die.
Wonderful. It is the first step on the path to enlightenment, or so I'm told.
Oh, no, no, it's definitely not my first.
Third, fourth, maybe even 50th.
Depends on how many times you count those career suicide missions. Did you ever see those?
No, actually.
The advanced combat tutorials consist of getting yourself killed multiple times intentionally.
See? Call me old-fashioned, but I can't think of any situation where dying is beneficial.
Well, one of them was like a straight-up suicide bombing of some sort of control tower. It was ridiculous.
Oh well, perfectly immortal, I suppose.
I think they wanted to show off the insurance system, which I'm becoming quite familiar with, all on my own.
Wonderful.
It feels like the Drake is missing most of itself. Like, it's just the armor plating and the rest of the ship has gone missing. Oh god, gonna die. The gate is gonna kill us all.
I landed right in the gate and then bounced off. Not good times. Right, going through.
I had my retriever and I was going out to a bookmark I made in a Veldspar asteroid. And the bookmark was inside the Veldspar asteroid. And it shot that retriever out at 2,000 meters per second.
Yeah.
It took me like Fun 5 times. Minutes to slow boat myself back to the fucking asteroid.
Yep. That's happened to me in missions once or twice. It's like, god damn it. Especially since I've started using a micro jump drive.
Doesn't that allow you to sort of reposition yourself across the battlefield?
Yeah, 100 kilometers at a time.
Awesome.
Alright, now, I am going to basically turn straight around and jump in that direction.
Okay, goodbye. I'll try not to bump you.
It'll take me a few seconds. Don't worry, I don't think the same thing would happen to me as happened to Zachty. Be safe.
What if I shot you at the same time?
Well, given the break, I still don't think it would really do that much. Watch when I jump. Wait, now. Hello! I'm very far away.
You just penetrated space.
Indeed.
So what are we supposed to do with this a-hole?
Damage it, basically. We're here to kill that, but at 80%, 50%, 30%, and once it enters hull, it's going to summon things to try and deal with us.
Why don't you get the damage started?
Yeah. Just activating my long range. Right, I'm stopping to attacking that, and I'm going to start going for the leap fritters first. Oh crap, I did a little bit too much damage in one go. God damn it, lasers.
Did you just summon multiple waves on us?
Two waves, yeah. Damn it. That does not look like 50% hull to me. That looks like it's at least at 53%.
Fortunately, these guys are targeting me, but they're not really doing any damage to me yet. Oh shit, I think that guy's out of range.
Don't worry, I can pop them in one hit. At least the frigates, anyway. I mean, once you start getting hit by the cruisers, that's going to change. Skill training
completed. Got my new hammerhead.
How's it going down there, Jeff?
I'm doing fine. They haven't hurt me yet. Or if they have, it hasn't done anything serious.
I've got you on my watch list, so I'll keep an eye on your health.
And I'll try not to commit any neighborhood crimes.
Thank you.
Seems like we're not having too much of a problem killing these things.
Everything has locked me, but is yellow, which probably means it's locking you.
Yeah, they're switching targets between us.
I don't know why they're switching to me. They're not going to be able to hit me from that distance. That's good if they are wasting their time doing that. The next wave is going to have two battle cruisers, two cruisers, two frigates. It's not going to have any elite frigates, so we don't have to worry about web or scram. By the way, do you have a mobile tractor unit?
No, none of these have dropped any loot yet either. I could go get one, but it's pretty far. Actually, no, I don't have one at all. Maybe there's one near.
Actually, what I'll do is I'll jump back to you. Oh, actually, my bastion module is just re-engaged. Never mind. We'll just kill this thing and we won't worry too much about the rest.
No, I can pick one up, one jump over from here real quick and bring it back if you want. Are you going to salvage these? Is that why you're wondering it?
Yeah, because you'll get decent things of it. But I've got one on me. It's just I've jumped a kilometer, 100 kilometers away. I'll jump back and deploy it in the zone. I always forget to deploy it when I land. I really need to get into that habit because then I jump off and I don't need it where I am, where I'm like fighting from. I need it where the gates are.
Indeed.
But I've got five salvage drones, so it shouldn't take too long to salvage those racks.
Nice. Do you want me to go give this mother drone some lovin'?
We are about to have its friends drop on us.
Okey-dokey.
There we go, it sent out the request. I'll stop attacking the mothership while we... Oh, never mind! It happened again. I'm gonna get you killed in this mission, Jeff.
Yep. Notice I went and stopped and got insurance before we started. I'm trying to keep myself sort of pointed at you so there won't be too much transversal on them.
Yeah, you're doing a good job of that, actually. The frigates have got no transversal at all.
I think you're still shooting at the mothership. Or is that shooting
no,
at you?
No, what happens is I target and go to shoot the small things, but it registers that my volley will destroy it in one go. And so then my target relocks onto the mothership and just the graphics look like I'm shooting at the mothership, but I'm popping the small things.
I see. Yeah, I've noticed I've sort of fired some of my missiles at some of them, and the missiles don't quite have a chance to get there.
Yeah.
Not a bad thing, because that means they're not getting to me.
Yeah, there is that. You know, look on the bright side. Right, I shall leave you to deal with the remainders there while I just finish off the mothership.
Okay.
Nothing quite like listening to classical music, sipping tea, and blowing things up in space.
By classical, I assume you mean Megadeth, right? Metallica?
I mean, I guess they were the metal of their time.
And these guys sure do not like dropping actual loot, do they?
Drones don't anymore. They used to. They used to drop drone alloys, which you could refine, and you could get some really rare components out of them. Rare minerals out of drone alloys. They were really good, but then it was all about salvage. Now, that was changed like over a year ago, I think. It was changed while I was playing last time, at least.
We did it! Room number one, anyway. How many rooms does this one have?
Let me see. Yeah, there's more pockets, so I'm just opening up the thing now.
That's alright.
There's auto aggro on warping, a single drone structure, may or may not drop a single low-end compound. There's three battleships, one battlecruiser, and a cruiser.
Okay.